Morning students of standard 11th. Today we are going to study topic parts of eye from chapter 21 neuron control and coordination. Parts of eye. The following are the parts of eye: cornea, pupil, iris, ciliary muscles, retina, aqueous humor, and vertebrae. Students, cornea, pupil, iris, ciliary muscles, retina, aqueous humor, and vitreous humor are the important parts of eye, where cornea is actually the non-vascular part of the eye. Since the concept of cornea can become more clear if you concentrate here, so you can notice here the cornea written, and this part which you can see is the cornea part, which is non-vascular, that is not provided with proper blood vessels. So cornea is a very important part of the eye. Cornea also gets infected with bacteria, and the disorder which is caused due to the infection of cornea by bacteria is called as conjunctivitis. Students, the next part is pupil, which you also can see here in this diagram. The pupil is the aperture by which the light enters inside the eye. Students, the concept of cornea we can understand more better in this diagram, where you can notice the cornea, which is this part. Students, it is mentioned here that it is non-vascular. Students, when we say non-vascular, then non-vascular means that there is no presence of blood vessels in cornea, and even it is transparent. Students, if you concentrate here, cornea will also appear transparent to you. Students, let's see how we define the pupil. Pupil is actually a narrow aperture in the eye by which the light penetrates in the eye. So students, here you can notice the aperture which is mentioned here and which is depicted here, the pupil, by which the light is going to enter inside the eye. Iris. It is the colored part of eye. Students, we can understand the concept of iris if we consider this diagram. Since here you can notice the part of the eye which provides distinct color to the eye, that is called as iris. Ciliary muscles. It is specific muscle which holds the lens intact. Students, if you concentrate here, you can notice that there is presence of ciliary muscle, which is also there given in this diagram. So you can notice here, this is the ciliary muscle which is depicted by this. Since ciliary muscle, you can notice that is present on both the sides, that means from the top also and from the bottom also. Students, the ciliary muscle is quite important to be present there inside the eye so that it can hold the lens. Students, here you can notice the lens also. This is the lens, students. This is the lens which you can see. Aquosuma. It is the fluid which remains present in between cornea and lens. Students, aqueous humor is actually the fluid which remains present in between the cornea and lens. So students, here you can notice the cornea and here you can see and notice the lens. Students, in between the cornea and lens, there remains present a particular type of fluid, and this fluid is called as anterior fluid, that is aqueous humor. So students, aqueous humor is very important for the incident rays to enter inside the eyes. Students, you can also find the vitreous humor, or is a fluid which remains present in the eyeball. Students, here if you will notice, then there is presence of vitreous humor, and this is the eyeball. Students, the eyeball of human beings is made up of three distinct layers. These are the outermost, that is sclera, which you can see here. Choroid, which is the intermediate layer, which is also quite distinctly visible in this picture. And the third, the innermost, that is the retina. Retina. It is the part of eye where images are formed. So students, retina actually is the part of eye where images are formed. Students, if we consider here in this picture, then we can notice that retina is actually the inner layer of the eye. Or we can say it is the most sensitive part of the eye where the image is getting formed. So students, it is the inner wall of the eye, that is the retina, where the image will be formed. The image formed will be inverted and erect. Students, after the image will be formed on the retina, this will be further transmitted by the help of optic nerves to the brain. Students, now let's discuss an important question. What is the function of ciliary muscle? The main function of ciliary muscles is to hold the lens intact.
Thank you, students.